So in this module, the first focus is on diffusing capacity. A diffusion capacity test is a test of gas exchange properties of the lung. There are different terminologies which are used, so it can be sometimes confusing. In literature, you will also come across diffusion capacity, diffusing capacity. Then there is also a term called transfer factor, which I will define. Now, gas exchange of lungs takes place at alveolo-capillary level, and it is impossible to physically measure gas exchange in the millions of airway spaces that we have. So this is a non-invasive test, a window into the pulmonary microcirculation, a window into the alveolo-capillary structure. So it is a measurement which uses principles of physics to estimate an average of gas exchange properties of the lung. There are different methods, a steady state method, a rebreathing method, or a single breath method. The method which is most commonly used is called single breath method using carbon monoxide. So it is written as DLCOSB. SB means single breath. Why we use carbon monoxide? What we breathe is oxygen, but when we do the test for gas exchange, we use carbon monoxide. The reason is that carbon monoxide and oxygen, they follow the same path through the lungs. Both compete for the same binding sites on hemoglobin. There is no carbon monoxide in the blood. So we don't have to measure carbon monoxide in the blood, in the capillary blood. Because we are interested in measuring the difference in carbon monoxide on the two sides of the alveolo-capillary membrane. On one side in the blood, it is assumed to be zero. So all we have to do is to measure the capillary, take capillary blood CO as zero and measure carbon monoxide in the alveolus. The rate of transfer of carbon monoxide is far faster than that of oxygen, and it binds to hemoglobin at a far greater affinity, 240 times fold higher than the binding capacity for oxygen. So that is the reason why carbon monoxide is used. Now there are several steps in uptake of carbon monoxide. We deliver carbon monoxide to the airways and the alveolar spaces. From there, in the last part of this path, the carbon monoxide diffuses mechanically in the alveolar ducts, air spaces and the alveoli. Then it transfers across the